Hello guys, this is Utagamon. In this video I'm going to benchmark Shadow of Mordor in crossfire mode on my two 7950s. I'm going to show you the system specs. Core i5-2500 running at 4.8 GHz, 16 GB of memory, and two 7950s at stock speed. 1 GHz is my stock speed. This is the frame rate result of the single GPU benchmark, and we'll see the difference of the dual GPU. Let me start task manager here, and I am launching the game. Show you the settings, 1080p, and graphics are at ultra, including the textures. As you can see, it says for ultra I need 6 GB or greater. My cards only have 3 GB, but Crossfire reports the whole memory as a whole, so thinks that's okay anyway. So I am at my tower, I'm starting the benchmark now. As you can see, the frame rate is quite nice. I want you to pay attention to the RAM and in general the memory that this game is addressing. Huge amount of data. Okay, let's see, the benchmark result was 80 frames per second, almost 30 frames more than the single card. And again, I remind you that this benchmark was with the texture set for 6 GB of frame buffer. The CPU usage was very high, as you can see, which is to be expected. And let's see what MSI Afterburner has to say about all this. Very high frame rate with inconsistent frame times. This will be remedied with some vertical sync. Very high GPU usage. CPU temperature was around 70, and the CPU usage was very high again, as you can see here. Huge amount of memory addressing. I don't remember having seen something like that before. This is a very good game for overclocking stability. And again, it reports 5.6 gigabytes, almost 6 gigabytes of memory of frame buffer, which I do not have. I only have 3 on each card. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys.